This is the CBS Evening News with Katie Couric.
During a search of Cho's dorm room, police recovered two computers, several books, his notebooks, and a digital camera. They're hoping tonight that these items will help them learn more about the gunman. More on that from our science and technology correspondent, Daniel Seberg.
Sung-Wee Cho's computers will be taken apart by digital forensics experts like Joe Caruso. He can expose secrets keystroke by keystroke.
Places that he went on the internet, what he did when he was there, if he viewed images, if he placed orders, different things like that. We can look at email that he sent and received from his different accounts.
Even if the author thinks they're gone. For example, these files were sent to the trash. Caruso uncovered them and others.
You see the date of the creation of the file and then the user that created that file.
Investigators use documents, emails, even instant messages to piece together motivation and behavior.
It's a very long process of going through everything that's on the hard drive and that's recoverable to make sure nothing's missed.
But how useful is that high-tech trail? Well, take the case of college professor Thomas Murray. When Murray was accused of beating his wife to death in 2003, it took cyber sleuth Dean Brown to crack the case.
Brown went to work, digging up everything Murray had typed into his internet searches.
One of the first things we saw was this term here, how to murder someone and not get caught.
He also discovered the meticulous linguistics instructor logged onto his computer like clockwork every Thursday. Those little blue bars represent time logged on. But the day his wife was killed,
no activity. He's not doing what he consistently did every other Thursday.
Other bits and bytes came together.
Guilty of murder in the first degree.
And ultimately, Brown's digital detective work sent Murray to prison for first degree murder. Obviously, the Virginia Tech families will never get that kind of closure. But the data recovered from Cho's computers should help answer the burning question. Why? Daniel Seberg, CBS News, New York.